Alright, now we're ready for our fried rice. So I've just got some broccoli here. I'm just going to throw that in first. And a pinch of carrot. Just stir them around a bit. And I've got my brown rice. Now I always put it in a few bits. I put a bit in just to get real nice crunchy bits. Start it off. And the way this bit dries right up. So you don't, your rice won't go bloody. A bit of time, you know. Doesn't take long to fry rice really. It's well cooked to start with. I'm stirring it around there now. I'm ready to put some more in there. I've just got to dance it around the side. So the middle of the pan stays empty again. And I'll put a bit on there first. So sit there for a second. Dance it around a bit as well. Mix it with the oven, dance it all around just a second. Get it out of the center again. Now I'll put most of the rice in sort of thing. A few handfuls now. And this way it'll all be, you know, a little bit crunchy. Last thing I'm going to put in this is a bit more carrot, so some will be a bit fresher, and a bit of beetroot and bamboo shoots thrown in there for good measure. Bit of colour, and there you have fried rice pretty much. Doesn't need much now. Always put a bit of mixed herb in my fried rice. There you go, really quick fried rice to serve with the little sushi and rice balls. I just put now a dash of real light soy sauce. Stir it around in that. And you can agree, it's pretty yummy. You can put a lot of other things in. I do actually pineapple, a little bit of capsicum. I'm not a big fan of capsicum. That's pretty colourful looking rice, you must admit. Really made in seconds and will be served with our little vegan sushis. Done with buckwheat butter.